Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays the Darkest Dungeon. My name is Stealwing 33, and today we have barely managed to recover from a nearly disastrous tumble down to no gold land. And this week, we gotta find something to do that, we have to do, like, a short mission that gets us something semi-worth our time. And I'm thinking that that might not be these arbalisk greaves, but it's better than, we don't need more deeds. We do need a lot more crests, though. So what I'm thinking is that we're gonna send out an antiquarian party, but I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna do, like, double abomination, this motherfucker, an occultist, and then, like, a front row antiquarian. This is dumb. Like, really dumb. Like, really dumb. Like, holy shit, dumb. Yeah, hold on a minute. You can go up front, though. Less good, because he can't do demon pull from there, but he can do all of his other shit from there. Prone to investigating the dark arts! He can fight carpentry, apparently, as well. That actually would be good. I think that makes him do extra damage versus the pews in the, that one boss fight, which is hilarious. But you're probably saying to yourself, hey, so, like, why are you doing this? And I'm like, well, we need money still. And this week fucking sucks because everything's medium missions, and that blows, like, major dick here. So we're going to do a short mission with these double abomination madness that we have going on. Yeah, so that's what we're going to do. So we're going to go in, but we're going to go send them in. I think we're going to send them in naked. I think we're going to send them in with no trinkets. Just because, like, I'm actually not hopeful that they're going to live. And we're also going to send them in without torches. But we're going to send them in with a good supply of food. Some those and some of these. And then we're going to go. The reason we're going to send them in with no torches because torches are expensive. It's 1,000 gold to buy 10 torches. Which is how many we would actually need for the cove. So we're just going to do it dark. It's a terrible plan. It's going to hurt. But I also don't really give a shit about these people. So fuck them. Like, it's fine. I know there was a patch for the Pitch Black dungeon here that caused a little bit. Some changes, like some of the hallways are now zigzaggy, like they actually like make sense for being inside of an ancient building. Like them being perfectly straight doesn't make any damn sense, like 90% of the time. Let's go ahead and drag you forward. He resisted it. That's okay. Blanket Fire's bad. But we didn't take any damage on a lot of our characters. She needs to be de-stressed. Badly. I'm not sure how we're going to do that other than camping. But, she definitely needs to be de-stressed as quickly as humanly possible here. It sucks that we got shuffled immediately. But, honestly, in the grand scheme of things, it's also not that bad. I will do Festering Vapors on you. Also, they changed it so that the taglines for these characters are now in like that gold font down there in the brackets. Very good. Very helpful, actually. Largely due to the fact that, like, because they are like that, it's easier for us to tell... it's easier for us to tell, like, what they are, like, where the bad guy... Like, the ones that we need to actually be worried about are... because I kept missing it because it was like the same color as their name, and so it's good. It's a good change. There are a couple of small changes here and there. I hadn't read the entire patch notes because I'm bad at my job. but there's some good ones. Some small aesthetic-y ones like the curvy paths and some of like the different lengthed route like hallways and stuff. Like this hallway over here is only one tile long, which I've never seen before. That's so much damage. Ow. We don't... Oh, no, I guess we do have a healer, don't we? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. A little bit of stress relief right there. It's good. We're good. Keep blighting him. I don't see any reason not to keep blighting him. Other than the fact that he keeps, like, blocking my blights with his bullshit. She needs to be healed, so next time a heal comes up, it's probably gonna go on her. Let's do Festering Vapors on you. There we go. Blight her up. Blight him up. Oh, yeah. It's a good heal. The bleed's bad, but in the grand scheme of things, it's not that bad. Blight him up. Yeah, blights. Blights are so good. They're especially good in here, if I remember correctly, because a lot of the enemies in here do not have very good blight resistance. This guy's dead, so we don't have to worry about him. And this guy's going to be dead next turn, hopefully, question mark. Hopefully we get a heal off before then, because I would like very much if we could heal this abomination. Yes, we do. And he got 7 is good. We're getting some dank heals right now, actually. That 5's a little nasty, and we don't have any good means of curing that, actually. So let's go ahead and heal yourself. There we go. A little bit of stress relief as well is not so bad. Manacle. He should be dead now, right? He's not dead, but he's gonna be. We'll spend a little bit of time just healing here. Let's do this. It's a debuff. It's an accuracy debuff. Do that. It's a small heal. Not bad. This guy's dead, so I'm not, like, worried about it. He's gonna drop dead from the blight, if you're wondering. He's got 8 blight this turn. So, it should be fine. Just gonna do a little bit of healing, a little bit of stress relief. Good. Dank. Oh, hey, look at that. A dodge stone. Yeah, why don't you take the dodge stone? There you go. Easy peasy. Let's go ahead and rearrange everybody. And let's get on with it. Cool. So far, not so bad, to be honest. This is an interesting shaped dungeon. A couple of these hallways are odd. So much blood. What is this? A sconce? Touch it. We didn't bring any torches, so... that's interesting. That's different than that was before. That's a different, like, curio. It's also shaped differently than it was before. Corrupting Sea Maggot seems bad, so let's get rid of you. Let's go hard to get rid of the Corrupting Sea Maggot. Hopefully. Blight the hell out of these two, and then we'll chain the Sea Maggot. Hopefully, question mark? Salty Gouge is bad. Nasty. The bleed's gonna be really nasty on that. Two's actually not that bad. It's better than I thought it was going to be. Mathen needs to get healed, though. Although he resisted that bleed, which is good. Chain that guy. He's dead now, so... There we go. Brine does low damage, but can cause diseases and other things. Great is the weapon that cuts on other things. Otherworld creatures. Got a frail deep stinger. That's another salty gouge. That bleed's gonna be nasty. Don't go before our healer so I can try to heal you. Oh, that's gross. That's gonna last a while. Let's bile you guys. Bile. Let's blight you, hopefully, question mark. Yep. Okay, the exact opposite of what I wanted to happen happened. He's dead. You're not quite dead. Let's chain you. Oh, damn it. Just really hoping to get that off there. And then no heal. But he resisted the bleed, so let's... A-okay in my book. The brine's bad. Does low damage, but sometimes it causes diseases. If we're not careful. Another 0? We used up all of our good luck on the last run. Or on the last fight. Shocker's bad, but it hit somebody who already took their action this turn, so it's not as bad as it could be. Festering Vapor on you. Blightachino. That guy's dead now. Gently. This is how ugh, that's bad. Manacle that guy. Hopefully it stuns him. It did not. Okay. Manacle that guy. Oh, that's Beast Bile. That's not what I meant to do. I mean, I guess it's okay, but not so much. Really need to get, like, we're gonna have to put some food down on these people. The bleeds have just been nuts. Really need to remember that bleeding is, like, my fucking worst enemy in the history of mankind. Every fucking time we come into one of these dungeons, somebody gets bled to death. Like, that's just what happens, I guess. Chain that guy. He's dead now. Nobody dropped dead. God damn it. No place for the weak or foolhardy. Brandel's resolve is tested. She's become selfish. Oh, she killed herself. Alright, goodbye. Now, here's the real question. Can I win this entire dungeon with two fuckers? I doubt it. We should probably just leave. Confidence surges. If I had a guess. Yeah, we should just leave. Leave and then we'll just scrap those two guys. Like, we'll just throw them away. And learn from it. Do I feel bad about that? No. Am I glad we didn't bring torches? You bet your ass I am. See something long absent in the sunken faces of passers-by. Sell the dodge trinket. A glimmer. Dodge stone's terrible. Gave us like a little bit back. We'll do another dungeon, don't worry. I'm just trying to think about like what we want to do. Let's check the stagecoach real quick. We have another occultist and an arbalist. So let's go ahead and kick you guys out. They're not worth fixing. The stress relief alone is like bad for us. We'll take all three of you. Pious and unrelenting. And then we'll pick a dungeon, I guess. We got double-edged pendant, paralyzing crest, whistle, healing armlet seems pretty good, actually. Let's go for this one. I know we don't need more busts, but let's go for that. And then we'll send Contaville in, because he's now stress relieved. We will send you there, and you there. Yeah, that seems fine. Will this work? No idea. Am I gonna go with it? You bet your ass. Actually, instead of the occultist, let's send Perry back out. Yeah, that feels slightly better. It's a little bit more damage, I guess. Now let's send you. You've got what? You've got Distab, Abyssal Artillery, Weakening Curse, and Weird Reconstruction. So really, you have Weird Reconstruction, Weakening Curse, and Sacrificial Stab. Having the extra heal might be worth it. Do we have anything that prevents nighttime ambush on these people? No? Okay. I guess we're going to have to live with that. Yeah, fuck it. Let's do it. We'll just send them in with lots of food. Food and shovels. That's the name of the game here. The only reason we're bringing the shovels is because if we don't bring the shovels and we bump into one of them, then we will get hosed. And I want to bring two keys because the keys are worth it because it might give us more gold. And that's kind of what we're hurting for right now. We're really hurting for it. Do 100% room battles. I wasn't even checking, like, what the hell. I want to make sure that people are in, like, the proper arrangement here. I feel like we are. I feel like this is fine. Ignore that. Books, though. Positive quirk. Unyielding. Unyielding's really good. Replaced Ruined Scrounger, which kind of sucks, but 10% death blow resistance is actually, like, kind of lit. Ambushed by and I don't say the word lit very often. Or at all, for that matter. I actually only started saying it because my sister started saying it, and, like, I don't know shit about, like, the fuck's going on with modern trends in English. Like, why is something lit? What the hell does that even mean? Like, it's not like, it's like a meaningless word. Like, in my head, when something's lit, it's like a bad thing, right? Like, the fuse has been lit. Or, like, fireworks are lit. A bomb's lit. You know? I don't know, maybe that's just me. Maybe that's just Maybelline. Let's go ahead and do one of these. Good. Not quite the damage I was looking for, but still pretty decent. I'm gonna heal her because she got hit by that trap earlier. Smack you. Probably should have gone with the one that does like slightly more damage, but kill that guy. Then I guess we can't actually. Oh, she can only hit the back couple rows. Oh, that's gonna be bad actually. Well, you know, not so much. She could be like a utility arbalist for right now. Until I can give her the like blind fire or something to that effect. Guy's getting stunned constantly. It's just like, let's just stun him up. Stun him up all day. Why not? Fucking YOLO. I wish you could heal yourself, so we'll mark you. The collect bounty does bonus damage to marked targets, I think. So like, that could be a good combo for end of fights, is like marking them, then killing them, and stuff like that. Let's just open it. Locking mechanism is trapped. The bleed's bad. The bleed's bad. Is it bandage bad, is the real question. Yes, that's bandage bad. It's 12 damage if I let that thing tick out, which is most of his HP. The trap has been rearmed, so we need to be aware of that. Who's got the best trap disarm? 50, 50, 50. Why don't you go ahead and disarm that? We're gonna be walking around in the dark a little bit, so the stress is gonna get kind of high, but we have good means of dealing with the stress. I do prefer to send out our Vestal with lepers, because their lepers are religious. I know that the occultist does not. Well, thank God we brought these shovels. I know the occultist does not, and then I know that, like, I think the arbalist might not be either. This could get nasty, by the way. Like, really nasty if we're not careful. The dark, the surprises could be really bad, but then even ignoring that, like, there are some really nasty enemies that could pop up in the dark if we're not careful. I probably should have brought the arbalist guy closer, to be honest. But that's a mistake. Not a bad mistake, but it is a mistake. Do a little bit of abyssal artillery. The debuff's nice. -5 dodge. Rallying flare, I guess. A little bit of light out of it. Interesting. It's no longer pitch black, which is good, I guess. Mace bash seems pretty good. Hit the shapeshifter. I know a group heal probably would have been good, but like that's not what we need to do right now. I'd rather do like weird reconstruction next turn. I'd rather wait a turn and try to do weird reconstruction. Although this is already proving to have not been a good idea. As life ebbs, unless he goes next. Let's go ahead and do this then. Get him off death's door, just in case. And then we'll weird reconstruction himself for 4, which is awful. And he bled himself, which is awful. Drag you in. Rallying flare, I guess. The problem is that I don't want to move her, right? Because it's such a waste, and then that'll make her Luvet actually worse. Because then Luvet won't be able to do her group heal, I think, because I think she can't do that from position 1. Which is really bad. Really bad. But we'll figure it out. I'm sure that there's a method to this. We just need to discover it and then do it. I mean, doing the buffing's not so bad. Grab you, because you haven't gone yet. I want to heal you again. He's, like, too hurt to not get healed. I don't want to lose anybody if we can avoid it, because we do need to win this mission. we needed to win the last one, too, but, you know. It didn't work out that way. Bumping the Knight's really not that bad. I've actually never seen one of these Bone Rabbles crit before, by the way. I say that now, and I'm going to get crit, like, next turn. Which is going to be hilarious. But, we really need to, like, do something about this. The shuffle fucked us, like, super hard. And I'm trying my best to deal with it, and it's just not working. At all. Faint hope blossoms. Bump of the Night's bad. Not bad, rather. Do this. That's a good kill. They're going to come back because they're corpses now, but I think I can deal with that, to be honest. Debuff resist is good. Heal a little bit. Really wish we had some sort of corpse clear, but we don't have one that I'm aware of. Like Uppercut might be one. They all came back as rabbles. That's actually ideal. Press this advantage. Give them no quarter. Let's kill you. There we go. If these two could hit them, that would have been great, but it's not going to happen. Hit you. He's going to come back as like another soldier, I bet. Just keep rallying flare, because why not at this point? Yeah, he came back as another soldier. That's not great. Not great at all. Let's do sack stab on you. Let's try to clear out some of this garbage here. Pull you in a little bit. Hit you with a mace. Good crit. Wipe that guy out. Before he can hit us some more. The damage is getting too much. We're going to have to heal with the weird reconstruction. We actually gained 30 light over the course of this. I'm going to go ahead and say that that was intentional. That this has nothing to do with me accidentally, like, giving... Like, the shuffle didn't screw us. It just gave me an opportunity to heal our torch light without using a torch. That was the plan all along. Clearly. Don't you guys see? Question mark? Question mark? That's not the dumbest thing I've ever done. Where did he come from? I thought we killed him. Oh well. We're in range to actually do some damage with an actual damage dealer now. Three heals bad. He can't actually do any of his shit from that position, so... Well, there's nobody to hit with Abyssal Artillery, and he can't sack stab from there. So it's not great to be in that position, to be honest, but we're gonna deal with it. Just keep building that torchlight, I guess. I mean, we're at 40. We've gotten a half-decent amount of torchlight. We are gonna need a camp after this, because that shuffle really did do a number on us. There we go. Kill that guy. Kill that guy. Thank you, God. Thank you. Jesus fucking Christ. Alright, let's camp. Let's reorder, then camp. Gonna get fucking hosed. I can feel it. Eat a feast. Just, God damn it. That was so bad. What do you got? Field dressing. Restring crossbow, wound care. Dark ritual. Plus 20 damage. Scout. Let's do the scouting chance. Let's do chant on you. I know it's like a low thing, but it's fine. Restring crossbow's good. I guess we'll do field dressing on yourself. No wound care on yourself. No. Okay. Guess let's actually just like we there's nothing else for us to really do. I guess we'll do this one. Everything else is kind of garbage. Wake up, they're upon us. Another fight, you say? It is on ambush. We're surprised again with our arbalest moving to literally the worst position she could move to. I guess this will give us the opportunity to get some fucking light going, but shit. Like, that's really bad. Let's drag you in so that way you can't crit anybody. I mean, he's gonna crit somebody anyway, but... Like, hopefully we can... Shuffling her back might not be a bad idea, because, like, he can do fine from the front. That should be fine. Oh, the double crit, so good. Bayonet jabs, not so bad. I don't know what to do. Let's do a group heal. Everybody's a little beat up, so let's do a group heal. We'll shuffle her backward, I think. I think that's like not a bad idea. Kill him. Oh yeah, the crits. The crits. Let's get another crit. Ah, damn, 10. Good kill. We'll shuffle her back. Like that. Anything's better than an arbalist. Even a soldier is better than an arbalist. The arbalists are way too strong. About to break. Yeah. She is gonna snap if we don't get rid of her stress somehow. But we don't really have any means of doing that. So, like, we're kind of hosed, I think. At least on, like, the stress department. Now, we could probably make something happen... Elsewise, like, we're not gonna not be able to kill stuff. But I'm a little nervous. I'm getting a little nervous. And I'm about to break. Oh, yeah. Snort. Heal her. Oh, that's a sick heal. That was a max that was a max heal and a critical strike, which is, like, super good. Hit that guy. Ow. Really wish she could battle bandage herself to get rid of that bleed, hopefully, question mark, but that's not gonna happen. Weird reconstruction for zero. It's good. It's a good solid zero. I'm happy about it. Don't worry, game. I didn't want you to heal him for very much either. It's cool. Touch that.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
Ruins adventurer replaced Reald Explorer. Alright. Get rid of the Nymphomania and we'll be in business a little bit here. Let's leave some food. That way we can try to heal ourselves in the future here. Just press onward. We're actually doing okay. The stress is a little nuts, but there's nothing we can't really do anything about that, to be honest. This team did not have the proper camping skills for dealing with that problem. Just touch it. Salvage an unburned torch. Take it. Hell yeah. Pop it immediately. Eerie presence is felt nearby. That's bad stress. Almost stepped on that. That would have been bad. I'd have been pissed. Okay, there's two battles this way. We have to go this way because we have to do the battles. It's like the whole point of us being here. Let's do these fucking battles. Salvage an unburned torch. Take it. Pop it. Fight the guys. Inspirational and shape-shifting, huh? Well, that's an arbalist now, so I'm not going to worry about him too much. Let's go ahead and try to wipe you out really quickly here to get rid of, hopefully get rid of the stress guys. That would be nice if we could get rid of that. Never-ending bones. Never-ending bones. Dodge. Dodge is not so bad. Kill him, please. Thank you. Ow. Sniper shot that guy. All the damage. So good. Would it have been worth it to try to kill the Skele-Man? Probably. But it's okay. Yeah, he just came back as a soldier. That other guy shapeshifted into a stress dude. So I'm actually glad that we hurt him a lot, because that could be... Breathes heavily. Yes, of course. Royal Bone Soldier probably is the next highest priority target. Now that the stress guy is gone. Well, gonna be gone. 7 damage, or 9 damage is really good, especially since this guy's only got 7 HP left. Ow. Kill him, thank you. Good. Because even if it turns into, like, another soldier, that's fine. Actually, I think that might actually be fine. We'll see. He turned into, it's a rabble and another soldier. It's totally fine, actually. I think it's fine, so, like, that's what I'm gonna go with. It could not be fine. It's fine. I can be on that train with you guys if you guys think that that's not a good idea. I'm definitely going to just keep killing these guys, I think. And we'll let the Vestal heal everybody. Probably should have shot the soldier instead of the rabble. Probably would have been better. That's okay. 2 healing is not enough healing. That group heal sucks so bad right now. I know it gets better as time goes on, but like, fuck. Punch this guy. Let's stun him. Hopefully... not get too much more beat up while we heal ourselves. Act 2 crit! So good. Let's do... weird reconstruction for 2. Awesome. And a bleed. Alright. I love it. It's so good. That's what I want, game. Bleed me more, Snake. Bleed me more. Bleed me more, Snake. I don't know, we're getting a little kind of 8-balled here. Oh, that 2 crit! No bleed? No bleed, though. Oh, man, what a... Why wouldn't you let me bleed, game? That's what I wanted. Dot, dot, dot. Don't tell the game I'm being facetious. Teetering on the brink. Don't hit my fucking bounty hunter again. Punch that guy. I don't want him to, like, get to go and then, like, kill our bounty hunter. Heal him. And we'll direct heal him as well. I don't like that everybody's so much slower than all of these guys. Like, it's becoming a problem. That's 3. Why can't you give me another 24? Give me, like, give me nothing but 24s for the rest of the run. Forever? Ooh, pretty good, actually. That stress relief's kind of important. He's still over 50%, which is kind of a lot. Shoot that guy. He's dead. I left a corpse behind. Probably, I did not even, I thought he was just another rabble. Became a soldier. That's actually bad. That's an upgrade from where he was. Stab that guy. heal. The crit's good. Not gonna complain about the crits. Low numbers, but they're crits, so they do cause stress relief, which is good. Kill. Battlefield bandage. We'll just heal a little bit, do a little bit of healing mill here. Nope, I guess not. We're gonna kill this guy.
Obliterated.
Good. Alright. Fantastic. On to the next fight. Every fight's like, we're almost gonna fucking die every time. And I'm like scared about it. Let's stab you. Then we'll judge you. I probably should have killed her instead of killing this guy. But the arbalist, the prophetic arbalist, scared me a little bit. Just enough where I was like, yeah, maybe. Maybe I should, like, be worried about that. But we'll see. Ow, that's a bad one. Yeah, that's bad. Not terrible, but bad. Stressful incantation's bad. The stress is gonna kill us. Like, that's gonna be our fucking downfall here. As it is in so many of these fucking dungeons. Good dodge. Happy about the dodges. I'll never complain about the dodges. Never, ever. Unless I want them to get hit. No, because even then, like, the only times I would ever want them to get hit would be situations where they're gonna, like, do riposte. But dodging, they still riposte. So, like, there's never an instance where I'm gonna complain that somebody dodged something. Come on, courageous. No, damn it, abusive. Abusive's bad because it causes stress to other people. Abuse is bad. It's a bad one. Let's punch you in the head. Send you back. Cut you down. Good. Heal everybody. Then shoot that guy. He's not dead yet. Getting there, though. Getting there, though. I feel like this might have been a better team. This team would have been better to send on the last mission we did into the cove. And then the team that was sent into the cove would have been better for here. Paranoid. Not great.
The walls close in. The shadows whisper of conspiracy.
Okay. I mean, whatever. It's fine. Actually, like, you can do that. That's okay. Like, whatever. Okay, fine. Heal this guy. Oh, yeah, baby. 10 critical heal. Helpful. Helpful indeed. Dead weight. Not great. Resisted both parts of it, though. Feeling good. Luckily, the fucking cultist corpses don't do anything. Like, they're just corpses. Which is super good. Punch you in the head. Yeah, I know with the fucking sacred fire bullshit. Just fucking kill the rabble. Oh my god, you suck! I'm abusing you now. Heal yourself. There you go. Shoot the rabble. These corpses are gonna vanish soon. At least I think they do. I think they should? I don't know. This is not real. We're in a video game. That would be the funniest one. Like, if they were like, yeah, the paranoid one, like, made him start breaking the fourth wall. We're being controlled by an outside force. A mighty stone triangle. I can see it in my mind's eye. Floating just out of sight.
Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates.
Yeah, we're going to have some more breaks as we walk through these hallways, because some of these dudes are going to, like, snap just from, like, ambient stress. Because, you know, this game wasn't hard enough on the stress factor, but then add in the fact that sometimes they just get ambiently stressed for no reason.
Holds much worse than mere trickery.
Like those.
And boogeymen.
Mere trickery and boogeymen. You heard it here, folks. What do you got? Minus two speed. It's actually not that bad. It's not herb worthy. Is that our last fight up there? Looks like we got one more fight, two more fights to go. I'm almost positive that treasure room's gonna have a fight in it. Just have you do it because you're already stressed. No secret room? All right, that's fine. Looks like one of these keys was a waste. Unless this is a locked box, in which case we'll open it. But we got two more fights to go. I think we can make this. I don't know if we're gonna make it with everybody still being unstressed, but how were they surprised? How did they get surprised? It's pitch black. I have no idea. Fucking, you know what? Don't look a gift horse in the mouth. How about that? Catch me outside. How about that? Contavil's resolve is tested. Focused. Nice. Super good. Clarity in the eye of the storm. Super duper super good. Cut that guy. I mean, everybody's already gonna break, so let's just kill the guy who's gonna actually, like, almost kill us. It's probably our best interest right now. Like, I know that this dude's gonna, like, do Tempting Goblet and stuff, and we might have more breaks, but honestly, it's gonna happen regardless, so I feel like it's not worth trying to avoid at this point. Fear and frailty. Fear's not that bad. Fear's bad because sometimes it makes them, pass their turn. But fear's not bad. It's not, like, abusive. Abusive actually causes problems for other characters, which is bad. I guess she causes it, too. That's not great. I guess fearful's still pretty bad. Cut you down. Oh, damn it. All right, fine. Let's cut you. Oh, yeah. Good crit. He's got extra crit from his thingy. Or is that from the from that knight statue we touched earlier? It might be from the knight statue, to be honest. Graveyard slash. They did the mash. They did the monster mash. The monster mash. It was a graveyard slash. Look at me. I've got to go to the dentist on Tuesday. I've seen this in my nightmares. All these guys, seriously, they all gotta go to the fucking dentist. I know that they're missing their lips and shit, but, like, fuck me, guys. You guys gotta, like, really take better care of your teeth. Oh, my God, with the misses. The misses are the worst. Ugh. Nice. Good. All right. Hanging in there. Or hanging in there. He's immune to the effect of her being abusive, which is nice. Like, really nice, actually. We can kill this guy in one turn, I think. Nope. Never mind. I mean, unless Contavil can, like, crit him. That would be nice. Yes! Yes! What up? Super good. Actually super good. Whew. Really cutting a close shave here, guys. Because there's not more food tiles ahead. I don't feel any reason to not do this. There we go. Cut a close shave. That's not great. Can you stop that, please? Hit some of the other guys. At least they're jackasses. Kill the horrific guy. Definitely needs to go. Tempting Goblet. Horrific causes a debuff, right? I think it's a stress debuff or something. Ugh! God, they miss so much. Supply ally something. I didn't read it. I should have read it. My bad. Punch that guy. Send him back. Send him back to the kitchen. Yeah, that's right. The back of the row is the kitchen. Fight me. How about that? You know, that first mission might have been a disaster, but this one's actually it's actually succeeding, which, I mean, it's still a disaster. There's still tons of stress. Oh, yeah, the crit's so good. Kill him. Oh my god! Stop missing! Just stop it! Get some help! Stop giving that guy bonuses. He fucking sucks. Gotta get rid of the bone courtier, because he might have a heart attack if we're not careful here. Graveyard stumble. They will flay us alive. So maybe you should, you know, shoot them better. Like, aim for the head. Or try to take an arm off. They're made of fucking bone. Should be able to hit them twice with a crossbow and make them explode. Gonna need heal now. I was like, that actually might be better to do right now. Let's do this. Get a little bit of light going. Not great. We really need to heal Contavil, because if he dies, we're gonna be more hosed. Like, hold fast or expire. Alright, good. Yeah, we got him off death's door at least. I mean, he's still on death's door, but like, you know what I meant. Injury and despondence. He's not gonna drop dead next time he gets hit. Visa. Don't get hit again. Work with me here. There we go. Get rid of that guy. Good, yeah, hit that guy. Fuck Bouvalant. Bouvalet? Bouvalet? Contavil cannot die. Heart attack. Yeah, he didn't die, so we're good. We're good. Everybody just hang in there for a hot second here. Don't die. Don't die. No! Damn it. Damn it. Damn it! Oh, well, we're hosed. We can't do this now. I mean, I've killed three of them already. I guess maybe we can. The problem is that Grimvoot can't actually hit people from there. I guess I could use her as a heal bot for the Vestal, but that feels like a terrible idea. I guess that's what we're gonna do? Question mark? Oh, but she can't do anything from that position. We'll just do Rallying Flare over and over again, I guess. Just kill what we can. We'll just whack them until they're all dead. She might be able to do it by herself. I'm pissed that Contavil died, because he's been around for a while. At the very precipice of oblivion. Heart attack! There we go. Stun's bad. The stun's really bad. We might have had a chance if that stun hadn't gone through. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm steadily becoming more and more convinced that we didn't have a chance at all. But, like, we might want to leave. Do we want to leave? Yeah, let's leave. Heart attack's bad. Leave the room. No, leave the combat. Don't fucking die. Don't you fucking die on me. Nope, there it goes. Alright. Yeah, that stun actually killed us. Yeah, holy shit. Well, group. Reassemble. We were so close. And demise. All the things are free this week, so I guess we can do some stress relief on people. Who's got high stress right now? That's not the building I wanted to do. This is the building I wanted to do. Yep, you're committed, you're committed. It's all free, so I'm not gonna... Can she only meditate? Okay. But she can't, because we don't have any fucking money. Alright, time to make some bad sacrifices. We'll get rid of the stun charm. We will get rid of this one. We will get rid of... What's, like, a good one? Let's get rid of this one. Not happy about that, to be honest. Shit. Alright, we'll get rid of this one. We need at least 3,000 gold. Let's get rid of this one. And we'll get rid of this one as well. Our Crusaders are all dead, so there's no reason for us to have Crusader things. The only reason we haven't sold the tentacle standard is it's actually like demonstrably worthless is because it only sells for 1 gold. It's not even worth selling. That's how worthless it is. I guess on the next episode we'll hopefully fucking figure out something to do here. I got another grave robber, another vestal, and another arbalist for the grinder, I guess.
Gold gleams like a dagger's point.
I guess we'd go to the cove and do this. No, I don't want to do... Because, like, what would we send in? We'd send in, probably... I guess Card's got no abilities, so he's worthless right now. We have to send somebody in who can hit stuff from the front row, right? So, like... Send in Pascal or Dismas might be able to do it. Like, we just don't have anybody who can be sitting... Who can sit in the front row. I mean, technically, she can... She could do pick to the face and stuff from there. But that's, like, terrible. Because, like, what would the team look like? It'd be... You'd be you. Probably Scoblin. Parasigma, right? Something like that. Like, that's how this would work. You've got mace bash, so maybe we'll switch you like that. So that way you can hit people with your mace from there. Like, this is terrible. This is a terrible team. We're really getting, like, really terrible rolls on the fucking stagecoach, man. We haven't gotten a single Houndmaster. We haven't gotten any Man-at-Arms at all. And I'm not getting any melee guys. I'm getting all ranged characters, which is not helpful at all. Alright, but that's gonna do it for this episode. So thank you all so much for watching. If you guys like what you saw, let me know. If you guys want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date. I want to post more videos. If you really like what you saw, leave a like. Helps the channel grow. Helps me out a great deal. But of course, with that, thank you all so much for watching. I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye!